Hey everyone, it's C Drama Invasion. Welcome to my channel if you're new. And today I'm back with another one of these Where Are They Now cast. This time we're doing Love 020 just because so many requests and there's just so many people who wants to know what Yang Yang and Zheng Shuang and also some of the other castmates are up to. So here we go. I'll leave links down in the description box of my previous videos. I did cover Arsenal Military Academy recently, and also I did Meteor Garden as the first one of these videos. So if you like to see a certain drama, make sure to comment down below in the comments and I'll definitely take your suggestion into account. Anyways, as always, like, comment, subscribe, and make sure to turn on that notification bell just so you won't miss out any of these videos and they'll show up in your subscription box. Let's start with Zhang Yecheng, who I just recently finished a drama with him in it. It was Love of Thousand Years, and that was his most recent drama. He played the supporting role of Haomei or Mo Zata in Love 020, and this was one of the friends in the group of Love 020. Anyways, he is born on August 26 in 1993, which makes him 26 years old. Since his appearance on Love 020, he actually gained a lot of attention, so he did star in his own first main role in 2017's Let's Shake It, and this was a series that was a fantasy romance comedy that was historical. I believe this followed a girl who was an alien who falls down to earth and meets his character. I believe he played some royal character, and it was a very funny but strange drama. Some of his other noticeable works are An Oriental Odyssey, where he played Mula as the main role opposite of Janice Wu, who you might know that was just in Skate Into Love. It was, I believe, her first historical romance drama, and it started off really good in my opinion, but it got a little bit weird or confusing in the end. And I've already mentioned Love of Thousand Years, which I won't mention again, but he did star in that with Zhao Lusi. And he does have two new upcoming dramas. So the first one is called Stealth Walker. This drama is a modern romance crime drama where there will be themes of undercover cops and about a group of young policemen who try to take down a drug organization. And the next drama that is rumored to air in 2021 is called The Sleepless Princess. This drama revolves around a cold and loyal general and a princess who suffers from insomnia. They spend their time reading together and eventually they fall in love. So this is a historical romance drama where he'll be starring with Hu Yixuan, who you might know from the drama I'm a Pet at Dali Temple. Next up we have Zheng Shuang, and she is born on August 22nd in 1991, so this makes her 28 years old, and I do have a whole in-depth video of her facts and profiles, who she's dating or dated, and all of that good stuff and possible dramas, but today I'll just talk about her upcoming works. And the first one that is, I believe, supposed to air in 2020 is called A Chinese Ghost Story, and this is going to be a romance, fantasy, supernatural drama. I believe it should be a costume drama as well. And she'll be starring in this drama with Neo Hu, who you might know from the drama When We Were Young. And even though there's a bit of an age gap, since she looks younger, I think that wouldn't be a problem. Anyways, this tells a story of a spirit and a spirit hunter and how they will fall in love after trials, and they realize through the greatness of love, friendship, and a student and mentor relationship. Next we have a drama called Clouds Cross the Sky, You Cross the Heart, or Crossing the Sky and Crossing Your Heart. This is a drama that stars Wallace Cheung as the male lead and Zhang Shuang as the female lead. This is a drama about romance, time travel, and pilots. So this plot begins with a beautiful female pilot and a domineering captain. During an accident, there was an accidental time shift which brought him back to the year he first met and fell in love with her. And of course, we have the long-awaited Jade Lover that is supposed to air this year. However, there's no real news on this because at first, I believe this year there was some type of announcement, but after the virus outbreak, none of that has been confirmed anymore, so we really don't know when it's going to air. But this is a romance fantasy that is a collaboration between Korea and China when they used to be on good terms. So this was Lee Jong-suk as the male lead and Zhang Shuang as the female lead, and a lot of people really love it. There's a 1-hour trailer up on YouTube, so if you want to see the cuteness and why everyone really wants to watch it, check it out. This story follows Zhang Shuang's character, whose family falls from grace after a bankrupt incident, and her hard-working experience helps her to grow and mature. Then she meets Bai Lohan, which is Lee Jong-suk's character, who I believe is a man who has ambitious goals and he is morally gray, so he works on both good and bad, and he might seem cold on the outside, but inside he's a kind-hearted man and he falls for her. There are rumors that one of the reasons why this drama is still not airing is because Lee Jong-suk is in the military and they want to have both actors present in order to promote the drama. So that does make sense, but unfortunately he did go to the military and we have to wait a whole year for him to come back, so we'll just have to wait and see. And for those who are wondering if there will be a collaboration between Yang Yang and Zhang Shuang, there is a very possible rumor that's happening where there is going to be a new fantasy costume drama that supposedly asked both actors, but we don't really know because there's no official post or anything yet. But there is a rumor that a new drama is in the making, and it is a historical fantasy costume drama called Zhu Yan. But there's also rumors that it might be a girl from Cosmic Girl or WJSN. But either way, I really hope this is true because they are very close. Still behind the scenes, he did send her a video message to say happy birthday while she was in a fan meeting, which seems that they are still on a good relationship or good terms, so perhaps they will work together again in the future. Now, of course, we have to talk about Yang Yang, the male lead, and I know you've been waiting for this, and I do have his previous video, like a full-length video, including his love life and what he's up to, not drama-wise only, but his personal relationships and also some of his background information in a facts video that I'll leave either a card or an end screen and a link in the description box below. So click on that if you haven't seen it already. Anyways, Yang Yang was born on September 9 in 1991, which makes him currently 28 years old. He has three dramas currently in the making. So the first one, which is the newest one that's been announced, is called Together. I believe he's not the main role in this, but drama will follow multiple leads. I believe it's like a couple of episodes per story, so he does have one of the main storylines, and it is a drama about fighting against COVID-19, the outbreak, so it's very recent and it's very relevant right now. So this drama will star a bunch of very popular castmates. So some of these very familiar faces or famous actors and actresses are Nini, Yang Yang, Sandra Ma, and Johnny Huang. And as you may know, one of his most recent dramas is The King's Avatar, and it did really, really well. So there was announced to be a second season, The King's Avatar 2, and it should come out in 2021 or maybe 2022. At this point, we're not sure because of the virus. They were supposed to film season 2, but they postponed it due to the virus, obviously, and we're not too sure if he's going to be the main role or not. There are mixed sources, so some people claim that Tencent did say that he will be the main role, and there's other people who said that he's only coming back as a supporting role. The King's Avatar is an action-adventure friendship e-gaming or sports drama. I personally have not seen this drama myself, but it's definitely on my top to watch list because Yang Yang, obviously, and it seems to have such great ratings and a lot of people really enjoy it. So if you enjoyed season one, hopefully he'll come back for sure for season two, and I will definitely be waiting for this season to come out. So if there's any major changes in the future, I'll definitely let you know with an updated video. So stay tuned and make sure to subscribe for that. And lastly, another drama that he's working on is called Glory of the Special Forces. And this is an action military drama about coming of age and police or military school. So this seems really interesting, and it sounds to me a little bit like Arsenal Military Academy, which I loved, and I did have a video on that, so make sure to watch that video after this one. But this drama will star Yang Yang and Lee Yi Tong, who you might know from some popular dramas such as Royal Nirvana and Bloody Romance. Most recently is her drama Sword Dynasty, where she stars with Der Li Xian, who you might know from Gogo's Squid. Anyways, this drama looks so good. I'll put some of the stills up right here, and it's so cool to see Yang Yang in military gear. He looks so awesome, and I cannot wait. I really hope this does come out soon. It says that it's supposed to come out at the very end of 2020, but to be honest, we're not too sure with the crazy outbreak and all. Okay, last but not least, we're going to talk about Rachel Mao, who is one of the supporting actresses. She is one of the best friends and roommates of the female lead, or Zhang Shuang's character. Rachel was born on February 16 in 1988, so this makes her currently 32 years old. Her most recent drama was as the main role in Who's Not Rebellious Youth, which was a modern romance drama. She has two dramas in the making. The first one is called Magical Legend, which is a romance, wuxia, fantasy, historical drama. This drama will also star Chen Ruoxian, and it is about a girl, which is played by Rachel Mao, who accidentally discovers magic and a fairy sealed, I think, book. It teaches you magical arts and the way to defeat evil forces or demons. And together with the male lead, I believe she teams up with him to save the world. And lastly, we have Nothing But 30, which will be a modern romance life drama. It follows three different women who reach their 30s while facing different challenges to take matters into their own hand. So the other two female leads are Maggie Jiang and Tong Yao. Anyways, that is it for this video. If you like these type of videos, make sure to subscribe, turn on that notification bell, and let me know in the comments down below what drama you want to see me cover next, and I'll see you next time. Bye.